one of two surviving members of the greatest musical group the world has ever known, the Beatles. Paul and John Lennon are, of course, widely regarded as the most successful songwriting team in the history of popular music, and with their bandmates George Harrison and Ringo Starr, the most influential and enduring act ever, owning the airwaves for the best part of a decade. Since the Beatles split 30-odd years ago, McCartney's released a succession of solo albums and, of course, recorded and toured with wife Linda in their band on the run, Wings. Musical exploits aside, McCartney shunned the spotlight, opting for a simple life, and by all accounts it's been a pretty good one, aside from a couple of notable tragedies. I spoke with Paul McCartney about the release of his new album, Driving Rain, the new love in his life, fiancée Heather Mills, the passing of his mate George Harrison, and those heady days of Beatlemania. Time to go back to work and make a new album?
Probably just, I've got enough songs, you know, I've got too many songs filling up my demo on my cassette recorder, and I suddenly think, time to make a record of these songs.
To what extent was this a return to the way you recorded back with the Beatles?
It was, to a large extent, really, because I happened to be doing an interview with someone, and I heard myself say, me and John would show up at 10:30 in the morning and we would show George and Ringo and George Martin what song we were going to do. And I thought, well, it was pretty amazing that George and Ringo didn't know what song we were going to do. So I thought it'd be good to try that again, because it kept things really very fresh. It meant that you were kind of making it up as you went along and you didn't have time to think, so you had to be very spontaneous. So I decided to try that out on Driving Rain.
One of the songs on the album deals with the night you met your late wife Linda, the song Magic, obviously pretty close to the heart.
Yeah, Magic was a song about the night I met Linda, and I was wondering, you know, after Linda died, whether I would find myself writing very sad songs about losing her. But it was kind of nice, really, because the song that popped out was this one about the first night I met her. And I used to say to my kids, you know, look, you know, I was in this club, I saw this beautiful woman, and she was just about to leave. And I stood up and said, hello, my name's Paul, what's yours, you know? And I didn't normally do that, but I suddenly felt I had to do that with this woman. And I used to say to the kids, if I hadn't have done that on that night, you lot wouldn't be here, you know. So it was quite a special night, so that was what Magic was about.
With this album, you've managed to do something. You've written two songs about two different women, because Heather, your fiancé, also gets a Guernsey.
Yeah, you know, it's funny. It's just my circumstances at the moment. You know, I've lost my wife for 30 years, but I found a new woman I love. So Driving Rain finds me at that position in my life, and you know, I like to be honest, so that's how it came out. You know, I just find there's love songs that I've written for Heather, and songs remembering Linda, and I think they kind of live quite well side by side, just because it really is, it's my story at the moment.
Were you expecting to fall in love again?
No, it's funny, after I lost Linda, I mean, as I say, married for 30 years and with four kids, I must say, I never expected to fall in love again, you know. But after I lost Linda, the question started to arise in my mind whether I would just kind of be celibate or how would it go, you know. So I decided to not really try and think about it and just see how it went. And so for about a year, 15 months or so, I didn't really think of anything but Linda. But then after then, I suddenly felt a bit different, and I happened to notice Heather at an awards ceremony that I was at. And just like when I'd seen Linda, I thought, wow, she looks great. And we later, after that event, we got talking, I rang her up. And I thought, wow, you know, I really fancy this woman, you know, and so we had a few more dates and I fell for her and she fell for me. So I felt very lucky, you know, because I wasn't sure which way it was going to go.
Of all the things you've done in your life and your career, what are you most proud of?
You know, I think I'm really feel very lucky to have had this gift of songwriting and singing and playing an instrument. So I feel very proud of a lot of the work I've done, and it's basically, I think the thing I feel most proud is the kind of message that it's all contained, or most of it is contained, which is one of sort of love for one another, really. It's kind of quite a peaceful, loving message in songs like Hey Jude or Let It Be, or more recently on the Driving Rain album, things like Loving Flame or Your Way. There's an undercurrent of sort of hopefulness and love. So I'm very proud that that's been in my work. I think that's what I'm most proud of.
Whenever we hear the name Paul, we always think of John, George and Ringo as well. In reality, how close were you guys?
Well, as close as you can be, really, you know. We knew each other, obviously, like a long time, and grew up together. We were all just Liverpool mates, and we kind of found fame together, got money together, toured the world together. And in the early days, I mean, we shared a van together, and in the British winter, you sometimes had to lie on top of each other just because it was so cold in that van when the heating went out. So it got pretty intimate, you know, we knew each other quite well. And, you know, you share each other's thoughts as you're growing up together like that. So in many ways, we are like brothers, really. And I think we all loved each other.
We all knew he was sick, but it still must have been a terrible shock when George Harrison passed away recently. How did that impact on you?
I was very saddened, because he's my little mate, you know. And like, I was in Liverpool last night. We're in Manchester now, we're doing this thing. And I was in Liverpool last night, and, you know, I was going down streets where we'd hung out together as teenagers. So it's very sad for me to lose my little mate, you know. But at the same time, because we had such great times and loved each other, I feel very privileged to have known such a great guy. And I'll remember the happy times, really.
You must be enormously proud of the music you've made over the years, are you?
I think when we were making it, you weren't aware of kind of quite what you were doing. You know, you're just trying to do good songs, sing well, play your instrument well. Over the years, it started to take on a significance, you know, as the people we made the music for have grown up, had kids of their own, their kids have started to get into the music. It goes through a lot of generations, so it's a lot of memories for people. It marks certain events in people's lives. Like, Americans will remember things like Give Peace a Chance or Let It Know is just the fame, as you say, in the music world. But later, and more recently, you realize, you go down the street and people will stop you and say, do you know how much effect, if only you knew what you've meant to my life, you know. I meet college kids and people say, oh, I was at college and I was having a terrible time doing my exams, but your music pulled me through, man. People who've been ill, you know, have sort of said things like that.
The great Sir Paul McCartney, whose new album Driving Rain is out now. There's a report in the paper today that he is the first, Britain's first pop billionaire.
Billionaire.
And those will be pounds that he's got a billion of too.
So that's plenty of billions,
that's
really.
Lots and lots.
Plenty
of
Australian billions.
Fantastic. He's the 11th richest person in Britain.
Why did he do so well when, say, George Harrison, I think George Harrison amassed something like 300 million, which is a fairly big difference. Why?
Right, he wrote the songs that the whole world sung. He and John Lennon, you make as much money out of the song. George wrote a few too, but
yeah.
And he was being really smart with his investments and et cetera, et cetera.
Good for him.